everyone, it's Monica, and welcome back to TaylorMade Cards for You. Well, today is the release of three more passport kits, and to celebrate, we're having a blog hop. Our blog hop is called Passport to Summer, and we're going to be sharing with you some projects featuring three new passport kits. Now, the kit that I'm sharing with you right now is the kit called Passport to Paris. And like my other kits, you're going to get four pages in each kit. You're going to get 2 5x7s. You're going to get a sheet with ephemera. And then you're also going to get a sheet that has the paper to create the passport base. Now, the fourth sheet is the 5x7 sheets cut down to 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And that way you'll have plenty of paper to work with your projects. Now, the second kit we've called Passport to New York. And as you can see, we have a travel theme going on here. I have found some really great vintage New York images to work with this kit. And of course, I had to create a brick wall so that way we can stamp some graffiti on it. Now, of course, I couldn't have a New York kit without the Statue of Liberty and the wonderful skyline of New York City. I also recreated a little New York Times paper that you can also use as ephemera. And then finally, my third passport kit is called Passport to London. In this kit, you're going to get a wonderful map of Europe, along with some great vintage tickets and a big picture of Big Ben. Now, just like my other kits, you're going to get 2 5x7 sheets and 4 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 sheets. And these are decorated with passport stamps from all over the world, along with some airmail envelopes. Now, when I design these kits, I create the base of the card so that way all you need to do is cut it out, and it's sized perfectly for a 5 1/2 by 4 1/4 card. You have a score line, and then you're going to trim it down like I have done in my other kits. And if you do need to have a demonstration or a tutorial on how to put together a passport kit, you'll be able to find that in my videos. But here, like I said, I just wanted to show you my completed cards. Now, with the passport kits, you can interchange the paper, so you can come up with so many different designs. This is just one example of how you can put together a kit. And as you see on this particular card, I put the passports in front, but you could easily put that Eiffel Tower in the front or any pieces of that ephemera. Now, ordinarily, I do create a little pocket to house my extra ephemera, but again, this is entirely up to you. My original passport card was a travel theme card, and as you've seen through my releases over the last several months, you can turn a passport card into anything that you would like. Now, this second card I created with the kit called Passport to London, and I created just a little bit different design by using some of the paper to create this large oversized tag. The design for the most part is the same, where you have this pocket on the last page to house your ephemera. And as you can see, you have some wonderful vintage ephemera that fits nicely in the pocket. Now, the last kit that I'm going to be sharing with you is called Passport to New York. And as I share with you my little card, I want to go ahead and share with you some of the promotions going on with my release. Now, ordinarily, I have a release of one kit, but because I have three this month, I am going to offer you a special where if you buy all three at the same time, you can get three for the price of two. So be sure that you look for that promotion in the shop. We're also going to be having a blog hop where my design team is going to be sharing with you their creations. And as you go through the hop, if you do leave a comment on their blog, they're going to be having a drawing in a week to give away one of the sets for this release. So the blog hop is going to start over on my blog at TaylorMadeCardsForYou.com. So head on over there and be sure to leave a comment, and then I will link to my other design team blog so that way you can hop over, see their project, and leave a comment as well. And then in a week, they're going to be doing a drawing, and we're going to announce the winners of the kits. So I hope that you've enjoyed my sharing my new releases for Passport to Summer, where I've shared with you my Passport to London, Passport to New York, and Passport to Paris. Be sure to leave me a comment and let me know which one is your favorite. And if you've enjoyed my video, leave me a thumbs up. I'll leave links to all the products below, as well as the link to my blog where you can start the blog hop. All right, everybody. Thanks so much for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.